Sometimes, between where you are and where you are going, it's hard to remember where you have been. There are very few who can truly say they still do. It's hard to believe that the story of the Bulldogs started 80 years ago. Before that, Canterbury was home to tough timber cutters and farmers. Then, in 1934, out of the Paragon Theatre in Belmore, a team named the Berries was born. So on Anzac Day in 1935, Canterbury's battle begun. The first year was hard. The club won just two games and succumbed to a 91-6 loss, a record that still stands today, and that was when tries were worth only three. It wasn't all bad in the beginning, though. Few would have expected the young club to succeed so soon, charging to premierships in both 1938 and 1942. Canterbury produced some of the finest players of the early 20th century. Blokes like Porter and Burns, who despite looking like a modern-day winger, epitomised the tough Canterbury spirit. And another, Kevin Ryan, who had shoulders tougher than concrete, left St George to pursue his dream of being both a captain and coach. He ultimately ended the 11-year reign of his old side, and then there was Bullfrog, Peter Moore, a man who saw what the club could become, described as one of the most brilliant innovators rugby league administration has ever seen. A man who said, "A club is not about the four walls surrounding us, it's about the people the four walls surround." And didn't he live by it? Football wasn't always about structure. Just ask Ted Glossop, a coach who told his players to throw the ball around, be creative. You won't see many better tries in a grand final than the one Steve Guerin scored in 1980, bringing Canterbury Bankstown its first premiership in 38 years. You'd be hard-pressed to watch a final during the 80s that Canterbury weren't in. Now named the Bulldogs, Canterbury were a force to be reckoned with. The Bulldogs won premierships in 1980, 84, 85 and 88. It was a hunger and desire to win, to walk that final victory lap in late September that kept the team going. When all seemed lost, there was always someone ready to step into the fold, like Farrer with his last-minute heroics in the semi-final of 1985. In 1995, in the midst of a battle between Rupert Murdoch and the ARL, the Bulldog spirit was tested once again. But it was a bunch of players who got together, had a drink, and decided to win the premiership for a man who typified what it means to be a Bulldog. The entranced watched on as magic was performed right in front of their eyes. The Bulldogs of the new millennium charged to an eighth premiership in 2004 against the Sydney Roosters. And in one of the most memorable grand final moments this game has ever seen, a young Jonathan Thurston handed his premiership ring to injured captain Steve Price. Blue and white rain from the skies. As a club, Canterbury continues to overcome all barriers in their relentless pursuit for a ninth premiership. I reckon if you ask anyone who had anything to do with this great club, they would tell you they are proud of their little home beside the train tracks. And so they should be. These are the moments we remember. These are moments we celebrate. We look forward to. This is Canterbury as we know it.
So many wonderful memories there. Tonight is such a special night because not many